Where do you want me to start?
From the beginning.
One late afternoon, a mysterious woman, who introduces herself as Dr. Reed Rosemary, visits the villa of the old notary, Richard Felton, whom suffers from a strange disease. He is assisted by his personal nurse, Gloria Ashman. After a brief and fruitless conversation, Reed is exposed as an imposter. She has come to the villa to find out what really happened to Felton's missing adopted daughter, Celeste. After being thrown out and refusing to give up, Reed hides until nightfall and sneaks back into the villa to search for clues. As Reed explores the villa, she soon finds herself in the center of her worst nightmare. Richard Felton has killed his wife, Ariana Gallo, and has lost his sanity. Upon learning that Reed has infiltrated the villa, Felton and a mysterious red nun begin hunting Reed. Reed eventually reaches the attic, where a mysterious girl who claims to be called Jennifer is found looming in the shadows. Reed eventually discovers that Richard Felton and the Jennifer in the attic are actually the same person. Richard Felton was born as a woman, but was then forced by her cruel father to live as a man. Phenoxyl, a drug created by Felton, the Ashmans, and Professor Wyman on the Rosagallo farms, was created from a rare breed of parasitic moths to repress and erase traumatic memories. It is revealed that the drug was tested on Felton and the nuns of the nearby convent. The drug caused terrible side effects: hallucinations, severe light sensitivity, and homicidal rage. As Reed was escaping Jennifer, Gloria returns to the villa and offers to help Reed. Gloria drugs Reed, and upon wakening, she finds Gloria forcing Felton to cut out his own tongue and burn himself to death. Gloria reveals that she is the Red Nun, the sole survivor of the fire at the convent, which was started to cover up the phenoxyl experiments. Gloria had been hypnotizing Felton for revenge. After a frantic confrontation, Reed manages to escape Gloria's murderous rage. Just before Gloria passes, she reveals that Celeste is still alive and that she had fled the Felton villa years ago. Reed must continue her search for unanswered questions. If Gloria was the daughter of Felton's associates, the Ashmans, why was she used as a guinea pig for experiments in the convent? Who were the Feltons protecting their daughter from? What happened to Celeste Felton?
You can't erase memories forever. It would be like erasing time itself. Memories and time go hand in hand. The consequences would be even more devastating than Alzheimer's disease. There would be no separation between pre- and post-trauma. The memories would wander autonomously in search for answers, for a common ground. Fractured by spells of amnesia, hallucinations, and emotional swings, two opposing perceptions would coexist, overlapping and threatening one another, to the detriment of the one truth, now shattered, the so-called porcelain memory.
Open my mouth! I'll keep everything to myself!
Ugh. And are you really suggesting that all this time, these people kept these experiments synthesizing this parasite, the moths, that were carried out on the nuns at the plantation a secret, making them intentionally ill as if they were lab rats? Just for this drug?
The phenoxyl. The farm, the moths. The hypnosis. And all those deep and dark family secrets. Family secrets are very dangerous. The most dangerous of any kind. The only way to survive was burying them so far down inside ourselves. And to move on. Richard Felton, Ariana Gallo, Professor Wyman, the Ashman sons, Stefano and Gloria Ashman, they all made a choice. And so did I.
So you chose to forget?
For 49 years. I left a part of me behind at that time. I did everything they asked of me. Forget. But one day, that missing puzzle piece resurfaced. Like dirt stuck beneath your fingernails. It is there, and always has been. Sometimes it is a song, a lullaby, or a certain item. But for me, that missing puzzle piece was a special person. A lonely one, just like me.
Yes. Hello? Who is this? Ashman?
Mr. Ashman.
Andrea!
The girl is here. Shall I let her in?
Go on. Sit down.
You know why you're here, young lady, don't you? I am willing to turn a blind eye to the money and the cigarettes. Don't be fooled into thinking that I don't know about them. But for everything else, I refuse to do so. This is not a tourist resort, nor a playground. Breaking an entry? Larceny! What plans did you have for that gun? For God's sake, Jennifer, tell me!
I don't know anymore.
It seems you are a magnet for trouble. From what I'm reading, you caused a lot of hassle, especially at the Flemington Girls Institute. Other girls similar to you ended up straight in juvie. Did you know that?
All I can do is apologize. I can assure you, I never intended...
Young lady, what are you running away from? You are safe here. You can talk to me about it.
I'm serious!
Very well. We will have to talk about this again. Considering what has happened, I have made arrangements to give you new chores. You will help Eliza in the kitchen.
But sir!
You will do your best.
I've always done my best here!
I seriously doubt that. When you become of age, you will do as you wish and as you see fit. But until then, you are under my care and you will do as I say. Run along now. Oh, and by the way, Lindsay will no longer be a problem for you.
What do you mean?
She insisted that I send you elsewhere. Instead, I have organized to have her transferred to another facility. They will be coming to collect her next week. You may leave.
The bathroom in room number 212 has to be cleaned. Oh, and don't forget that you'll be helping Elisa in the kitchen after lunch.
Okay.
You've really done it this time. Make sure that the two of you don't get him agitated after his parents' death. Mr. Ashman Jr. did everything by himself here.
What happened to them?
Dead, my dear. Like all those who grow old. And I'm sure the mourning sped up the process.
Mourning?
For the nearby convent. Have you seriously not heard of it? The convent just went up in flames one day. Even this building was partly damaged. A dozen nuns died in that fire. Mr. Ashman's sister, Gloria, being one of them.
That's terrible.
They had contracted some sort of disease. They practically went blind. They had gone mad. And that Dr. Wyman? Sure as hell didn't help them. Poor girl. She was locked up in there by her own parents.
Why?
Hi, Jen. Oh, Andrea. I'll start with room 213.
Did Mr. Ashman have something to do with it?
Shh! Lower your voice! You'll get us thrown out of here. It seems that Mr. Ashman had the bad habit of touching his little sister.
Oh, God!
Obviously, the parents didn't like this at all. So they sent him to a family relative in the north and his sister Gloria to the convent. If it were me, I would have done the opposite. For him, the arrangement only lasted a few months. For her instead? Well, that's another story entirely. He had always been Mommy and Daddy's sweetheart.
I can't believe I'm still dragging around this lice-infested suitcase. I've had it since I was at the Flemington Institute. Locked. Locked. You scared me!
Oh, I'm sorry.
Ever heard of knocking?
No way. But it's so last year. Everything okay with Ashman?
Of course. Fantastic. Never better. Everything is great.
He got angry, didn't he?
Why would you care, Lynn? Tell me.
I was just asking.
Asking what? It's none of your business.
What are you talking about? You can't be upset with me forever.
I'm trying not to be, but my arm keeps reminding me.
I didn't mean to. It was only an accident. Do you have any idea how guilty I feel? Jen, please. I feel so shit about it. I didn't want it to get to this point.
I already know it all. Ashman told me everything.
What are you talking about?
You suggested to him that I be transferred elsewhere. Is that what you wanted?
You're really a bitch sometimes.
A bitch who let herself be fooled. But no, in the end, you withdrew yourself. You didn't want to get in trouble.
I didn't want to get in trouble. Well said! You think we would have gotten away with it, right?
Go away, Lynn. Leave me alone.
No! You're going to let me speak.
Go away!
Then please! Open the fucking door!
The door! Fuck you, Lynn! Fuck you!
You were just loyal. I thought we knew each other, but I was wrong.
Go away. I beg you. My God, I have to leave this place at once.
Will reopen in late spring. Until then, I will only see the same ugly old faces.
Trainer activated.
What does it mean? If this is a joke, I don't like it at all, Lynn. Locked? This door has never been locked before.
I'm exhausted.
Any guests at the hotel. Who could have ordered a meal?
What the hell does Acherontia mean? What the fuck? What the hell did they do to you?
You know that you call him Wyman once upon a time!
Andrea! You're hurting me!
It's part of all of us. And we are all part of the same thing.
I don't want to die! I don't want to die!
Locked. Where are you hiding, you slut? I knew it! Actually gets any work done around here is me. It would be best if I just told him I don't work with crybabies.
This is all so surreal.
Jennifer. Don't make me lose my patience.
Be the hotel's older wing, the one which was engulfed and destroyed by the fire. Andrea really suspect that someone was poisoning her? But who? Oh dear, what happened? What? It's Andrea. Fuck. What the hell is going on with you, Andrea? I must warn the others.
This is supposed to be a hotel, but it feels more like an orphanage.
final calls, only to other hotel rooms. It works! Make sure not to get caught. Oh God, I hope they don't find out.
It's coming from room 213. Who's wasting my time? Locked. There's no power. It won't work. Break from it all. I told Ashman
but we didn't need desperate children. This is supposed to be a hotel. It feels more like an orphanage. I'm so tired of all this. I just want a break from it all.
In order to factory reset your save, insert the following code. 3, 2, 1, 4.
The only one who actually gets any work done around here is me.
Locked.
Thank you. Ashman, but we didn't need desperate children.
Yes, yes, yes! The French window. Just doing here. Felton? Gallo? So, this is the real reason why Rosso Gallo closed its doors. Dying like that, painfully, it would have been the same for any other person, especially after everything they went through. The mirror. It couldn't have shut it by itself. I saw it.
What's going on? Mommy is coming.
Andrea, I have to hide.
I'm so tired of all this. Shh. Calm down. Calm down. Everything is fine. Mommy is here. Migraine. Mommy is exhausted. One of these days, you're all going to make me crazy.
Young lady! What do you want? Come get it! Where were you?
tough. I'll show you, bitch. They mustn't find me.
Young lady, don't make me get angry. Girls, filthy girls.
My God, I have to leave this place at once.
This is supposed to be a hotel, but it feels more like an orphanage.
To make sure they don't find me.
And see us. You've already seen who lurks inside the walls, haven't you? Do you? Sure, hide! Hide away! I knew it! You're going! Slit your throat, you bitch! What are you doing here? I'll make you pay! Thank you.
play? Let's play then!
No, that's impossible. I have to try again.
Oh.
am here, working my ass off.
Why are you doing this to me?
I knew it! Did you hit me?
Where were you? Where do you think you're going? Jennifer!
Locked.